Yeah.
Yeah.
I just want to give a big thank you to Marilyn. I'm going to tear up here right off the get-go. But that was a tribute to our Nora Cochran, a song they played together many times at Easter. Okay, now? All right, there we go. Anyway, and it just meant a lot for her to play that today as we remember our dear Nora. I am sure her presence, I am feeling her presence, that's why I got some tears, but also her giggle, because those who knew her, she had a pretty good giggle. So anyway, so we're just going to start, and my name is Gwen Hoody. I'm your master of ceremonies for today. I'm probably going to get a little mixed up, but we're going to get through this. So that being said, if you could rise for our opening hymn. All are welcome.
Thank you.
So welcome, welcome, all are welcome, as we sang in our opening hymn. And a very special welcome to all our visitors and our special guests, who I will be introducing later on. Welcome to those joining us on the live stream. We are going to set on a journey of celebrating our 60th anniversary. Anniversaries are to be celebrated in remembering our past, but not focusing so much on what was in the past. We're going to look towards the future as to what God has in store for Good Shepherd Lutheran Church. So on this anniversary, we affirm the Lord's guidance over our church. And I am filled with joy and excitement as the Holy Spirit is present and we celebrate this special occasion. I have had the privilege and pleasure of chairing our 50th anniversary. That was a 50th, 10 years ago, when my memory was a lot better. And poof, here we are at 60. And my memory not so great. So in advance, I ask for forgiveness if I forget something or someone. I have no claim to have shared 60 years, like some of you have, with Good Shepherd. But my boast is that this coming November, it will be 25 years that I was baptized at the font, and I'm not sure where they moved it to, but at the font, and became a member. And that has allowed me to share in the 40th, the 50th, and now the 60th. I'm wondering if by a show of hands or standing, if you're able, if we have anyone with us today that would have been present at the very first service that was held in this, what was a not finished church, and became this beautiful building as it stands today. And the first service was held on December 24th, 1966. So is there a show of hands of anyone that was with us that day or standing? There we go. Yay. Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to acknowledge the presence of Marguerite Gibbons. Can you put up your hand, Marguerite? There she is. And she is the lovely lady that made the motion to name this Good Shepherd Lutheran Church. That is your claim to fame, Marguerite. There you go. And we thank you for that. And today, I also would especially acknowledge a very special person. I don't like to just pick certain people out, but I feel this one in my heart deserves a special thank you. He's a person that we call a fixture in this building, and that is Lorne Shibley. He was a member of the first confirmation class in this church, and he has continued to be a very, very faithful servant here. He has been an usher for years, trained under the leadership of the infamous Peter Temple, and after Peter's passing, he took on the role as our head usher. And he takes his role seriously. He is here all the time, being that person to open the doors and have everything in order. Most of us don't even have a clue what he does until those Sundays, like last Sunday when he wasn't here. And we scramble, let me tell you. And unfortunately, due to his health, this is one of those rare days that Lorne is not with us. Health issues have kept him away from this day that I know he was looking forward and it would have meant a lot to him to be here. So I'm just going to ask that we keep him in our prayers for healthy days ahead. And he'll watch this video. So for him, I would like you to give him a big round of applause. Thank you, Lord. So let's begin our program. And as much as this is a celebration, it's also worship. So we ask that you hold your applause till after the choir sings, "Thank you, Lord, for our blessings." That's the song, because the choir is going to be singing. Lots of people are going to be singing. And just know that if it goes a little long, that there is a fine line between a program, a celebration, and a hostage situation. So just stay seated until it's over. So at this time, I am going to call on Pastor Ron for a prayer of the day.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our everlasting God, the one who is gracious to us, the one who has journeyed with us in these past 60 years, the one who has given us hope, the one who has gathered us here to bring his glory to us. We thank you in a special way for the tender care that you have granted us. You have kept us safe until we have met in this manner. We have joy in our hearts, Lord God, because you are a loving God. And such as this you have shown us as we start this commemoration and celebration of our beautiful faith family, Good Shepherd Lutheran Church here in Melville. We want to remember your goodness, Lord God. We want to remember your faithfulness that you have granted to us as a church. Lord of Lords, may we continue to see you revealing yourself among us. Let your mercies continue to shine upon us, O God. As we begin this service today, we invite the Holy Spirit to abide with us. And may you guide us and protect us until we finish. Thank you, Lord, for hearing and answering our prayers. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
I've been healed by the Savior. I've found fire from above. I've been down to that river. Ain't the same prodigal return. All my hope is in Jesus. Thank God that yesterday's gone. All my sins are forgiven. I've been washed by the blood. I'm no stranger to the prison. I've washed shackles and chains. I've been freed and forgiven. I'm not going back, never be the same. So I sing, all my hope is in Jesus. You thank God that yesterday is gone. All my sins are forgiven, 'cause I've been washed by the blood. There's a kind of thing that just breaks a man, break him down to his knees. God, yes, I've been broken more than a time or two. Yes, Lord, he picked me up, showed me what it means to be a man. 'Cause all my hope is in Jesus. You thank God that yesterday's gone. All my sins are forgiven, 'cause I've been washed by the blood. 'Cause all my hope is in Jesus. You thank God that yesterday's gone. 'Cause all my sins are forgiven. I've been washed by the fall short. I've got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do. And I And you never do. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a king, except for a heart singing hallelujah, hallelujah. I've got one response. I've got just one move. With my arms stretched wide, I will worship you. So I'll throw up my hands and praise you again and again. 'Cause all that I have is a hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I've nothing else fit for a king, except for our hearts singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, my soul, don't you get shy of me, lift up your song. You got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Come on, my soul, don't you get shy of me. Lift up your song. You got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Come on, my soul. Don't you get shy at me. Lift up your song. You got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Hey. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again. Cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I have nothing else fit for a king except for a heart singing hallelujah. Hallelujah,
Hello. This is actually a song done by Faith Hill, if you guys are familiar with her. It's kind of contemporary. Kathy Doug knows what I like. Might have to go a little bit up there. Just a little bit volume there. Trying to understand how the world could be so cold, stealing the souls of men. Cloudy skies rain down on all your dreams. We wrestle with the fear and doubt. Sometimes it's hard, but you gotta believe there's a better place where a father waits. And darkness will be gone, the weak shall be strong. Hold on to your faith. There will come a day. There will come a day. Wars are raging, lies are scattered. Innocence is lost and hopes are shattered. The old are forgotten, the children are forsaken. In this world we're living in, is there anything sacred? There's a better place where a father waits, and every tear he'll wipe away. Darkness will be gone, the weak shall be strong. Hold on to your faith. There will come a day.
There will come a day.
Thank you to our musicians and our special guests. And just know that I forgive you all for not holding your applause, as you will forgive me for the mistakes I make going forward. So at this time, we're going to all have a chance to sing. And I would ask you to rise, if you are able, to Jesus Paid It All. At this time, I would like to call up and introduce to you our newly elected bishop. Bishop Alley, please come and share some words of wisdom with us.
My dear sister, there's a problem with what you just said. Everything else was good. The word wisdom has nothing to do with me. Now, to get some wisdom, let's hear from the gospel. The gospel, according to St. John, the 20th chapter, beginning at verse 11. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there. But she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not touch me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Infinitely gracious God, abundantly loving God, the hearts of your holy people gathered here at Good Shepherd in Melville rejoice as they give thanks for 60 years of your faithfulness, 60 years of their ministry, 60 years of the Holy Spirit leading and guiding them. Be with us as we give thanks. Be with us as we celebrate. Be with us even as we dance. May your Holy Spirit, present in us, with us, and around us, guide us. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. On behalf of your sisters and brothers, siblings throughout our Synod, the Saskatchewan Synod, I thank you. I thank you for your faithfulness. I thank you for your years of dedication and ministry. I thank you for following Jesus where he has led you and continue to lead you and all of us. I thank you for being a beacon, an example, a model for the whole church in our Synod. 60 years is a lot of years. 60 years is many, many years, 6 decades. Growing up in Cameroon, in Central Africa, if you're wondering where it is, I usually refer to its placement, its position, as being in the throat of Africa. If you can identify Africa as a head with a neck and so forth, then Cameroon would be right there at the throat. There in Cameroon, growing up, life expectancy 25 years ago was 46 years. The average person lived to be 46. And my mother was, for the most part, as we grew up, very frail. My mother was sick a lot. We thought we lost her many, many times. You see, memory has a way of playing a trick on us. The good old days we remember, right? It seems that our memory erases the bad days from those old times. And the old days are known as only being good. When we're honest, those days weren't that good all the times. There were elements of goodness to those days, but there were significant challenges. The past often is no different from the present. The past is like the present. It has its challenges, but it has its joys as well. But is it then possible to conclude that there's nothing in the past that we want to keep in the present? Of course not. There are always things that are precious in the past that we want to keep forever. And when we think about the good old days, I think we're thinking more in terms of those things that we cherish. Not to say that those days were only good. I'm sure we remember those challenges. And so as we face these challenges that have come our way in our society, and the church is affected by those challenges, we wonder and long for days past. Looking back is only helpful insofar as it helps us march forward. If we look back to lament, it is not useful. But if we look back to see in the past the lessons that we have learned, and that will help us move forward, then the past is extremely helpful. And so when we look back at your past as a church, we see a faithful church. We see a church that has served well. We see people through whose ministry our synod has been made better in its overall ministry. And so thank you for that ministry. As Mary, we ponder though, We stand at the juncture of life and we wonder, how long are we going to continue to be present? I have good news for you. The good news is that it does not depend on us. It depends on God. It depends on the Holy Spirit who leads us each and every day. It depends on Christ, who is the church, who is the one leading us, in whose hands the church fate stand. And so the good news is we can relax because Christ has the church in the palm of Jesus' own hands. And so we can relax. Around Christ we gather. With Christ we journey. And that journey will continue. And so as disciples called by Jesus 60 years ago, you are here, continuing the journey. You have gone from being disciples to being the sent out ones, to being apostles. And now you are both at the same time, disciples and apostles, serving as well as learning, listening as well as speaking, proclaiming as well as studying. You are the treasured people of God, called to serve God, called to serve one another as you bring the gospel to the world. As hands and feet of Jesus, you proclaim the gospel in tangible ways. May your faithfulness continue. May your zeal for Christ continue. May your faithfulness in the walk of the gospel with each other, with the world, and with others around the country and overseas, may that zeal, may that faithfulness continue. You have siblings, sisters, and brothers in Christ who walk with you. You are not alone. The Holy Spirit is with you always. We know that. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, is with us each and every single second. We know that. But your siblings, your sisters and brothers across our Senate, in other denominations, right here in the city of Melville, in the whole province, in the whole country, around the world, your sisters and brothers, siblings in Christ, are with you. Your walk is a walk whereby you are not alone. It is a walk that we embark on together as the people of God, treasured in the task and ministry that Christ has given us. The problem is often we find ourselves isolated from one another, divided, whatever those divisions may be. In those times of struggle, remember that Jesus is standing next to you, calling you by name, in the same manner Jesus calls Mary at the tomb when she thinks all is over, all is finished. She realizes that it's only the start, it's only a new beginning, springing forth with her and with others as well. She's now tasked to proclaim that new beginning to all. And so for you and all across our church who are wondering, thinking that maybe this is the end or the beginning of the end, the good news is it is not. It is only the beginning of a new life. And so continue with faith, trusting in the God who has called us together. The church will never die, for the church is the body of Christ. And you are part of that body in your faithful ministry here at Good Shepherd. You are blessed to have one another. You are blessed to have those who have served before you, who are now saints in Christ, with Christ, who are watching, smiling, clapping, rejoicing today as you celebrate the work that they were a part of. You are part of this whole journey whereby others celebrate, congratulate you on this milestone. So it's not just you, one another, and the whole church. It is those who have served as leaders in this church. I just had the privilege of attending Pastor Ivan Moen's funeral not too long ago. We give thanks and praise to God for his ministry here, as well as other subsequent pastors who came, all of whom were faithful servants and leaders in this place and in the whole church. Today, I give thanks to God for Pastor Ron. A few weeks ago, when I was in Kitchener for Bishop Carla's ordination, I almost got killed there. Bishop Michael Price told me, "You stole our pastor." I wondered, which pastor are you talking about? I knew already, because it wasn't the first time. But this time he was more vigorous. Pastor Ron. They blame us for stealing Pastor Ron. "Thou shalt not steal." But for this one, I don't apologize. Hallelujah. I give thanks to God for Pastor Ron. Thank you, Pastor, for your ministry and your leadership in this place. Remember that you come in a long line of faithful pastors who have come before you. I heard this from one of the greatest pastors of our church, Pastor Orville Kaminsky, when I was called to serve the congregations in Radnor and Fairy Glen a number of years ago. He came and he told me, "Others who have come before you, including me, we took care of the seed that God planted here at Carroll River Valley Lutheran Church and at Beaver Creek Lutheran Church. You have now been called to continue to tend to the plant. We will pray for you as you tend to that plant." Pastor Ron, dear brother, God is with you and with the whole congregation, the whole people of God here at Good Shepherd. God will see that God's work is done as you lead the people here. And so, please support your pastor as you've always done. If you don't support your pastor, you know what will happen. No, just kidding. Please continue to walk hand in hand with your pastor. Be united in the ministry to which Christ is calling you. For the task is challenging and requires that you be united as God's people. Be united with St. Paul's Lutheran Church as well, the other congregation here in town. Forget about the challenges of the past and come to each other with open arms to embrace one another and to look to the mission, to the ministry that Christ is calling you to be a part of. Open your hearts and minds to serve the community here in Melville and beyond. For there is plenty of work, and there are only a few of you. Since there are only a few of you, I have a challenge. In the next 12 months, my challenge is that you find two people that you would invite to be a part of the work of this church. The first place to invite people is not worship. Worship is the most challenging place to bring someone who is new. Bring those people that you invite to church activities, to opportunities of service that you have in the community, where you're serving others. not yourselves. Two people, each and every one of you gathered here today. If you invite two people who have never been part of anything that Good Shepherd is doing, you have done well. And those two people will pick it up from there. Whether it is joining the congregation, who knows what that is, but your task is to invite to a function of the church. That's one way of stepping out of your comfort zone, because what I'm learning is we are never as happy or committed to inviting people into our lives of faith. In Fairy Glen and Radnor, when I mentioned this to them, they said, "We are Norwegians, we are Scandinavians, and we are shy." And I am a scientist, for those of you who may not know. So I don't just accept things. I try to see if there's evidence for that. I'm a little bit like Thomas, who would like to see evidence before accepting. I know it's bad for a bishop. But you know what I did? I ran an experiment. Out of the blue, 1 week I targeted a Labor Day classic. And I said, we will be going to Regina to watch the Rough Riders playing against the Blue Bombers. And a few people signed up. There were about 18 of us driving from Fairy Glen to Regina for the Labor Day Classic. I will tell you that what I observed there was nothing that I ever observed in church. When the Rough Riders scored a touchdown, they were jumping as high as they could, high-fiving anybody around them. The shy Norwegians, the shy Scandinavians, were now the boisterous, joyful, you know, out there, you know, Rough Riders fans. We have it in us to spread the good news. It may be that we have been conditioned to not sharing our faith. I invite you to break out of that mold and to share your faith gently. One of the reasons we don't share our faith is because we've seen bad examples of how people share their faith. By the way, I'm only halfway through, okay? We've learned the bad, you know, we've had enough bad examples of people sharing their faith. One day I was, as pastor of Resurrection, I was walking from the church to, I forgot where I was going, but I turned left at that intersection with Russell on one side and Primrose on the other. I don't know why in that area of the city, street names change just like that. Anyway, when I turned left, I saw a man walking, and I like saying hello a lot. And that day, I wish I had not said hello. I said hello as this man walked past me, and then he had passed me already, and he walked back and said, "Have you received Jesus as your Lord and Savior?" I said, "Oh my God." Those are the examples that we don't like when we think about sharing our faith. But we have to share our faith. We have to. You see, Mary cannot keep it quiet. How can she? We have to. It is an imperative. The good news is too great for us to keep it to ourselves, but to share it with love, with grace, with openness, with respect, but to share it. You've been doing that. You've been doing that through your actions. You've been doing that a lot through your ministries. The challenge is you have not invited people enough. You have not spoken enough. Once when I was struggling, and my wife and I, we were struggling, we saw someone who was helping us. And one of the issues was that I don't say, I love you enough. I said, but she knows that I love her. The therapist said, no, it's not enough for the person to know that you love her. You have to tell her. And he said, she is a woman. I don't know what he meant by that, but we have to speak the love. We cannot just say, they know. No one, not everyone is watching us. We have to engage. We have to speak the word. We have to invite. We have to make the beautiful ministry of Good Shepherd available for others to be a part of. Good Shepherd shouldn't be a secret. The ministry of Good Shepherd shouldn't be a secret for only those who are privileged enough to know about those. You should break it open and share it with everyone. As the people of God in this province, in this synod, I encourage you to please two people. Invite two people in the next 12 months to some function of this church, and the rest will be in their hands. The Holy Spirit will lead them where they need to be led. As you do that, and as you continue in the excellent ministry that you have carried out in the past 60 years, God will walk with you as God has, so that for the next 60 years, we are back. I won't be back, can tell you that. But others will be back to celebrate the 120th anniversary of this church, this beautiful faith community. As you do that, may Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless the word in your hearts and in your minds. Amen.
Thank you very much for those wonderful and encouraging words. I ask you, if you're able, to rise and sing our congregational hymn, Christ Be Our Light. And at that time, I'm going to ask the men's choir to get organized at the front. Where are they?
Oh,
You may be seated, and I'm going to hand it over to Melville's men's choir.
Footsteps walking with me, footsteps I cannot see, but every move I make and every step I take, I know they're walking with me. They walk with me all the way, beside me day by day, through good and bad, through happy and sad. Those footsteps won't go away. I'll never walk in life alone. There'll always be someone there. I know he won't let me down. He's with me everywhere. Special things in life I've done. I've been through him and his love. Someone I can't see. I'm not always sure where to go, but that's when I follow his lead. I know that the pathway that he shows will help me to succeed. Footsteps walking with me, footsteps I cannot see. Every move I make, every step I take, I know they're walking with me. They walk with me all the way, beside me day by day. Through good and bad, through happy and sad, these footsteps won't go away. By my side.
Just a little talk with Jesus made me whole. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little prayer wheel turning. Know a little fire is burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Sometimes my past seems drear without a rapture. And then a cloud of doubt may hide the light of day. The mists of sin may rise and hide the starry sky. But just a little talk with Jesus clears the way. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little prayer will turn. Know a little fire is burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. I may have doubts and fears. My eyes be filled with tears. But Jesus, a friend who watches day and night. I go to him in prayer. He knows my every care. And just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. Hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little prayer wheel turning. Know a little fire is burning. Find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
As everybody's getting settled, I took note about you inviting people to things. Well, I don't know how many of you, by a show of hands, get a lot of calls from telemarketers. So maybe we should invite them to church when they phone. What do you think of that one? I'll try. Okay. We were blessed with a beautiful day. We all know that winter is fast approaching, and a lot of us are probably planning some winter vacations. Anyways, I found a little joke that said a man dies and he finds himself standing in front of St. Peter at the pearly gates. St. Peter says to him, I have good news, and the good news is that you're going to stay here. The bad news is your luggage has gone to hell. I'm sure some people have had that experience. But anyway, okay, at this time, I would like to ask our council chairperson to join me up here, and we have our introduction of our special guests with along with some gifts. Now, I just thought of something, Pastor Ron, for maybe for some people, if you could acquire a microphone so that they maybe don't have to come up here. That maybe will be great. But anyways, we have a lot of pastors in the house, which is just wonderful. But not having served here, but in our presence today, I would like to acknowledge Pastor Kim Sherwin, who has, please stand. I'm just, no, it's okay. I'll just want them standing. Don't make them, that's their day off. So, and in our choir, we have Pastor Rebecca. And she has joined us. She lives in Grenfell and is newly serving. Okay. But we also are now are going to give thanks for the amazing, you may be seated, my dear. Okay. She listens well. Give thanks for all the amazing shepherds of our church that have served the congregation. It started out with Reverend Ivor Moen, who, like the bishop said, just passed away this April, and I've had some contact with his family. And I did get a reply from Marlis saying that she was planning to attend. That's what I'm trying to find out, because I tried meeting her out in the narthex, but Marlis, if you could please rise and introduce, there she is, way back there. We welcome you and our condolences again on losing your father, and we'll visit with you downstairs later. And then we have, next was Reverend Oscar Johnson, who is a man I got to know because his eldest daughter and I became very, very good friends in high school. And we have not seen each other in 41 years. And that's crazy. But anyways, I would like to introduce and get the Johnson family, because all four of his children are here, and I'm sure there's many here that remember them as little people or younger people, right? Right, okay. So we have, starting with the oldest, we always start with the oldest, I'm the oldest, right? Is Ruth and her husband, Kim Roosevelt. Please rise. Come on. Come on. And then in birth order, I'm going to go out on a limb. Do we have, stay standing. you can still do it. Joanne was next. Yep, I'm doing good. And then Kathy. Right? And Jason, who went on to become a pastor, which is just wonderful. So Pastor Jason Johnson. Yes, thank you so much for coming. It means a lot. Then we have, I see him, sun's coming in my eyes, Jerry Burkowski, Reverend Jerry Burkowski. Jerry, are you able to make your way to the front? Can you make your way to the front, please? Can you come up here? Okay, all right. His claim to fame is he was the only pastor that smoked a pipe back in the day. Yes, it was. But most importantly, he played a big part in helping bringing Pastor Ron to us. And on behalf of Good Shepherd, we would like to pretend... You got to find his name. All right. We would like to present you with this stole as a commemoration of your time served here and celebrating this day with us. And then, you can. And then we have Pastor Darlene Harrison. Do you want to make your way up here? Okay, you can do it. We are just... Her claim to fame was starting our Gone Country Beef Supper, which still goes today and is one of our major fundraisers that we host every year. Then we would have Reverend Doug Schmerler. And his claim to fame, or one of them, everyone has many, but I'm just picking something. It wasn't so fun. For he, along with his beautiful wife, Bonnie, they had to navigate this church through COVID and help us be able to still minister during the shutdown. So we thank you for that. You receive our gift. Then we would have our Pastor Ron. And one of his claims to fame is his love and enthusiasm for singing "This Little Light of Mine" over and over and over again. And last but not least, our newly elected and installed bishop, Bishop Alley. You get one. You get one. Yes, you do. I had the pleasure of attending a very moving Christmas Eve service at his church when he served at Resurrection Lutheran in Saskatoon. And the music that night was so beautiful. And it included someone that played a baby grand piano, which inspired me to come back to this congregation and obtain our baby grand piano. So you had a little part in that. Thank you. Okay, so we'll move along, but not present. We continue to keep in our prayers and give thanks for the service by Reverend Roger Haugen, Reverend Linda Woke, interns Kelly Henning, Alan Pino, Mabel Wu, David Jensen, Prima Samuel, Colette Baker. With great love and faithfulness, they have supported and guided us in our ministry. And lastly, I would like us to take a moment of silence and prayer as we remember all those pioneers and family loved ones who have taken their last walk down this aisle as we celebrated their lives and the end of their spiritual journey. Their hard work and their dedication and visions have and will always be remembered till we meet again. Okay, I'm finished. All right. Well, you'll still hear from me, but we're gonna ask the choir now for our two closing songs. I don't have any more jokes, so if anyone does, they can stand up and tell one until we get organized. Thank you. Yes, and I'm going to take this opportunity. We have a choir loft full of youth, very enthusiastic young people that are managing the screen and doing all the technology and bouncing around up there to all the music. So thank you to our youth group. Okay, so where do I go now, Pastor Ron? He was telling me yesterday, we did the singing, and now do I do the announcements before you do the closing? Okay, anyways, too many thank yous. Thank you to my choir, or our choir, to Carol, and all these amazing musicians and everybody that joined us to make this day a very special day. And to Pastor Ron, who kind of leads us with all these microphones and telling us he's some of the smarts behind all of this. He is. I just would like you to know, this thing is bothering me. Pastor Ron has been working really hard, and we were hoping to have it done. And it's just about done. But he's been working on a documentary to record the history of Good Shepherd Lutheran Church in a digital form, because we have books and books and books and books and paper, but according to these young people, that's kind of not where we're going, right? So, that being said, he is doing a fantastic job, but unfortunately was not able to complete it. So, we're going to have a little bit of fun with that, because this way, inquiring minds are going to want to know. So there will be a sign-up sheet in the back. He is promising to have it done by the end of November. And you can sign your name if you would like to order one for $15. If it needs to be mailed, unfortunately, it'll be $20 with postage. But we're going to have a bit of a fundraiser and some fun downstairs during the supper. The very first copy is up for bids. To have the bragging rights to own the first copy made for the history of Good Shepherd Lutheran Church. So we're going to have a little bit of fun with that. Okay? No. Okay. I have to say a big thank you to the credit union who printed our programs for us. A correction in the program. Pastor Ron is not a doctor. If you look into tomorrow's, he is listed as a doctor, but I have no doubt in my mind that he couldn't be one day if he would like to. So everyone is welcome to continue our celebration tomorrow morning at 10:30 with the worship service. And just a reminder that there is a potluck after the worship service. Now, it's crazy, I've got something on the back up here. There's also going to be an anniversary choir singing tomorrow morning. We will be meeting in the basement at 9:15 to practice our theme hymn. And we are going to be wearing our choir gowns. These gowns, unfortunately, are going to be worn for the last time at this anniversary. And they will be decommissioned, and our hope and our dream is to have them packed up and sent over to Africa someday for some people to enjoy them there. So I think that's all I have to say. I will probably forgot something, but thank you for your attendance. I see smiling faces. I know it's gotten a little long. So I will call on Pastor Ron to do the closing prayer and the sending.
So in the Lutheran tradition where I come from, a pastor cannot give a benediction in the presence of a bishop. So what I'll just do is to do a closing prayer and invite the bishop to come and give us a benediction. Let us pray. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Dear Lord, our Heavenly God, we thank you for this wonderful, wonderful celebration. As we look back over the 60 years that you have blessed us with, and also as we look into the future to see what you have prepared for us. Lord God, we pray that as we are gathered today, help us to dream for the years to come. Help us, Lord God, to embrace your love, to embrace your joy, your laughter, as we journey into the future. Bless us, Lord God, as we continue to celebrate today and tomorrow. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. And now I will invite the bishop to come and give us the benediction.
Thank you, brother. He wouldn't let me get away with being dressed otherwise. So, thank you. Thank you once again for your faithfulness, for this wonderful celebration. Thank you for being the treasured people of God here at Good Shepherd in Melville. May your good work and your ministry continue. And so as we leave this holy place for a time of more celebration downstairs, may Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen.
As we dismiss, I didn't get around to calling some of the people when I can't find my list. The clergy and council and the choir,
thank you so
any
much.
People that took part in the service, if you could stay at the front, we'd like to do some photos, okay? But our photographer has to run on this, yes, unless, do you want to do it? Back there, we've got our Melville Advance. Is that okay, Cindy? Yeah? Okay. Unless you want to both do it, all right? But feel free, those that are staying for supper, you can head downstairs, catch the ear of somebody that you know, share some hugs, and the rest of us will meet you downstairs, okay?